Welcome to all. I am Suryakant Tarte, Assistant Professor, Shiv Shankar College of Agriculture, Engineering and Technology, Mirasgaon. Today we will see about the artificial recharge of groundwater. Artificial recharge is the process by which the groundwater reservoir is augmented at a rate exceeding that under natural conditions of the replenishment. Any man-made scheme or facility that adds water to an aquifer may be considered to be an artificial recharge system. The basic purpose of artificial groundwater recharge is to replenish the groundwater, to check decline in water table, conserve water for future use, control of saltwater encroachment, etc. Most commonly used artificial recharge methods can be classified into direct method, indirect method, or it may be a combination method. First one is the direct method. The direct method include surface spreading, subsurface technique, and combination of surface and subsurface techniques. First one is the surface spreading technique. Groundwater recharge by surface spreading method means infiltration of water from surface of the soil through the paddle zone to the saturated part of the aquifer. The downward movement of water is governed by number of factors like vertical permeability of the paddle zone, presence or absence of limiting layers having low vertical permeability, and influence of physical, chemical, and bacteriological processes. This figure shows the flowchart of artificial recharge method. The methods may be direct methods and indirect methods. The direct method consists of surface spreading techniques and subsurface spreading techniques. The surface spreading techniques consist of flooding, ditch and furrows method, recharge basin method, and of conservation structures like the use of gully plugs, vein terracing, contour bunds, nala bunds, percolation tank. The next method of surface spreading technique is the stream modification and surface irrigation. The subsurface techniques consist of use of injection wells, gravity head recharge wells, connector wells, recharge feeds, and recharge shafts. Indirect methods consist of induced recharge, aquifer modification, groundwater conservation structures. Induced recharge, there may be a pump, use of pumping wells, collector wells, and infiltration galleries. Aquifer modification, the modification in the aquifer properties can be done by bore blasting or hydrofracturing. Groundwater conservation structures like groundwater dams or underground bandaras and fracture sealing cementation technique may be used in indirect methods. The requirement of successful recharge through spreading methods consists of sufficiently thick permeable unconfined aquifer, permeable surface soil to maintain high infiltration rate, permeable paddle zone free from clay lines, sufficiently deep groundwater level to accommodate the water table rise without causing waterlogging, moderate hydraulic conductivity of aquifer material, and gentle sloping land without gullies or ridges. We will see the next method of recharge is the flooding. This method is the least costly of all water spreading methods. In this method, the surplus water from the canal or stream is diverted to the adjoining areas through a canal delivery canal. Embankments are made on two sides of the area to ensure proper contact time and water spread, as well as to put back the unutilized surface water to the canal upstream downstream. In addition to the requirements for spreading method described above, the specific requirement of this technique is the availability of sufficiently large area adjacent to the canal upstream, which is normally not used for any other purpose and can be legally acquired. Next method of artificial groundwater recharge is the ditch and furrow method. This system is usually used only in case of irregular topography where flooding is not possible. The water from stream is diverted to the ditches through the delivery canal or supply ditch to a network of ditches spread in the area. Excess water from the ditch is diverted back to the canal or stream. And the next method of artificial recharge is the use of recharge basins. The basins used for artificial groundwater recharge are either excavated or enclosed by dikes or levees. We will see these in figure 1.2. They are commonly built parallel to streams or at other locations to which the water can be diverted from the recharge source. In alluvial areas, multiple recharge are used. You can see this figure schematic sketch showing the layout of recharge basins. You can see here the basin and interbasin control structures. The stream flow is there. The water is diverted by using divergent structures. At the entry of recharge basin, there is a sediment retention basin to trap the fine sand particles at the bottom of the structures, because this fine sand particles enters into the recharge basin or interbasin, then it may reduce the permeability because it may fill up the pore spaces. So the sediment retention basin is used at the entry point of the different recharge basin. By using the different recharge basin or interbasin control structures, the water is diverted throughout the entire area. So in such a way that the water has enough opportunity to percolate downward. This system has a number of advantages, such as efficient use of space and reduction in suspended matter. When water flows from upstream basin to downstream basin, the specific characteristic and design guidelines consist of the bottom of individual basin should be sufficiently wide to permit movement of scrappers for desilting operation. The inlet and outlet of the basin should be diagonally opposite to permit adequate water circulation in individual basin. Water released to the basin should have minimum sediment. The infiltration capacity can be improved by alternate loading and unloading, periodic scrapping of top surface layer. The design of basin may be based on the actual infiltration study. The next structure is the percolation tanks. The percolation tanks are small water harvesting structures created by making low elevation stop dams across stream, or located adjacent to a stream by excavation and connected to the stream by delivery canal. The requirements of successful recharge operation through percolation. High permeability of rocks under submerged areas, uniform degree and extent of bedding of rocks, sufficient rainfall ensuring filling of percolation tank every year, light sandy soils in the catchment area to avoid silting up of bed. The size of catchment may vary from 2.5 to 8 square kilometer. Existence of good phreatic aquifer with lateral continuity up to the percolation tank. Adequate number of groundwater structures in the benefited zone of percolation tank to fully utilize the additional recharge. The next structure is the stream modification. The recharge through the natural streams or drains can be increased by determining the stream flow and stream bed area in contact with water. The method used include provision of low head check dams allowing flood flows passing over them and construction of yield-safe levees in the stream bed allowing the passage of flow in a zigzag manner before the start of rainy season. This method has been successfully used in alluvial areas but also can be used in hard rock areas in the case of faded rocks. Next method is the conservation of water resources in agriculture field itself. The declining water table can be controlled either by reducing the groundwater trap or increasing the groundwater recharge. Both these objectives are achieved by conservation of rainfall or the surplus canal water during rainy season in paddy or sugarcane field. The water conserved in the field meet partial requirement of irrigation and thus decreases the groundwater trap as well as increases the groundwater recharge. The runoff conservation structures such as check dams, gully plugs, bench terracing, contour bunds, improved agronomic practices, etc. induce more infiltration, enhance groundwater recharge.